Hello and welcome. This is Alex, and this is my Let's Play series, episode 19. I got over 1,000 views now, and thank you for that, everyone. I really appreciate it, so thank you. I don't really have anything planned for this episode except kind of a status update on how things are going at my base. So it's been a while since we looked at the mushroom farm. So I thought we might climb up there and see how the mushrooms are doing. So let's see in here. Wow. They're really multiplying. The only places they haven't spread to is right next to the torches, because this is light level 14. This is 13 here. And 12. And 12 is the maximum light level that a mushroom can be in. So they're not gonna go near the torches. So I'm not gonna go hungry. This is insane. Well, I'm just gonna leave it for now. I don't need to pick them all up. So let's see what's up here. Well, there's nothing new up here. It's not the most efficient setup, but it works, and I get more than enough of the stuff I need. I know some people spend a lot of time in optimizing their farms and making sure they get all that is possible, but I don't really think that's necessary. Well, I don't need unlimited stuff of everything. I got more than I can handle already. So here's my dog from last time. I've had a few suggestions for his name, but I think he's gonna be called Steve. Yeah, how are you doing, Steve? Are you doing good? Yeah? Good doggy. So let's see, I did a few things since last time. There's nothing new here. This is same old, same old. Stuff from the hostile and passive mob farm. I did do something down here, though. I'm gonna show you. So the tree farm, like I showed you last time, and I finished off this project over here. So I'm gonna show it to you. Ooh, a cactus. Well, I built this last time, and since then I hooked up the node blocks here to play a little tune. And if we're lucky, we might get to see a cactus come by and play the tune. And the first one to guess the name of the tune gets a little plaque put up, a sign put up down here. Oh, that wasn't. Oh well, I'll just take the ride. There. Oh well, I'm gonna wait up here till I can just throw this in, I guess. Oh, there's one. So let's see if you can guess it. Don't know if it's perfect, but we're gonna play it one more time so you get a chance to listen to it again. So there you are, that's the tune I hooked up. I found the sheet music for the tune, and I made sure that the note blocks are playing the right notes. So that's it. till the machine is finished. It's not for generating cactus for me, it's just for fun. I wanted to see if I could do something with it. I just made it play that little tune. And down here, I built something new. So let's see if we caught anything in it. Oh, it sure sounds like it. You're never gonna guess what it is. Yeah, it's another slime farm. Wow, there's a lot of guys in there. I'd say this is quite effective. Let's see if I can survive in here. Just need to get all the big guys, cut them into little guys. Yeah, come on. Bring it on. Bring it. Oh man, there's a lot of these guys. They kept spawning in the... I had a lot of dungeons down here I was lighting up, and they kept spawning. And I'd got plenty of slimes from just wandering down into the dungeons now and then and killing off the slimes that had spawned. But I thought I might as well make an area for proper slime farming. So I just carved out this space here. I looked up the slime farm thingy on the web, and I saw that I had two chunks right next to my base where they were spawning. So I just made this room my usual style, with the torches in the roof, so to prevent hostiles or mobs from spawning. Oh man, they keep on coming. Die already! Well, this could go on for a while, I guess. I already got a stack of... Oh, stop pushing! I already got a stack of slime balls. What's down here? Oh, just a little one. Oh, they're so cute. So this is just a door out to the... It is just to the cave, the caverns around here, that I didn't want to block it all off. There's no... I don't really need to go down here. I just wanted to leave the option, and I didn't want to punch through the wall every time I wanted to go through. So, let's see if I can get the door closed again. Did one get caught out there? I think one got caught. Nah. So. Finally. So how much did I get? I don't know, I'm gonna check, hang on. Pick all these up. Almost two stacks, wow. So, it's working, it's very efficient, way more than the last one I did. Thank you. So I'm just gonna put them in here. Yeah, got some materials for digging this out, I got some diamonds as well. I don't know if they're still here. No, I put them up in my box. So, I'm going to take a little break, and then I'll get back to you. So, see you in a short while. Hello again. We're down here at the basis from last episode, where I built the obsidian machine. And earlier today, I watched Etho's new video, where he explained and showed how to... make use of the new X-ray tip or exploit or glitch or whatever it is. So what you do is you make a 1x1 square with TNT next to it and two sticky pistons, and you activate them and squash yourself. And when you do that, you can see all around like this. So you can see if there's any, or there's some dark areas over there where I still need to light up the caverns. So I'm gonna make a few of these around. I made another one, so you just jump to get out. It's very simple, two sticky pistons and redstone going over here to activate them. You need to be careful not to make the redstone go past here. This block or this block should have no redstone, because then the whole thing is gonna go boom. And I did try that. I made another one of those. I'm going to show you where it is. And I made that mistake, and I blew everything up and stranded myself underwater. No, you don't. Come here, you ninja chicken. Die! So, let's see if we got anything good. Well, we got lots of stuff. I made some TNT because I needed it for the X-ray trick. So I got a stack of TNT now. Oh, I forgot to put these in the box. So let's go look at the other one. It's right outside my door here. I'm just gonna. Hello, Steve. Are you doing good? Yes? No? You want a steak? Here you go. Good doggy. Okay. Just right out here. What was that? Ah, a chicken. That's good. So, I made another one down here. And the reason this area is so large is because, well, you guessed it. I made a small room down here. And I made the redstone wire go past this block, and I blew it all up. So, don't do that. So, as you can see, this isn't very effective because I can't really see much else but my base. But over here, there's some dark areas down there where still a lot of slimes are spawning, and I got some caves I still need to light up. All the dark tunnels over there and down there. So, well, and then you just jump to get out. So, I think that's it for this time. It was just a little update video to show you how things are going and what I built. So, that's it for now. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed it. See you next time.